Okay, there's been enough time since the Bridge episode aired for me to talk about it, so this video is going to be about one of the biggest takeaways for me, and it's the fact that Rue lied. She revealed to Ali that the Rule's tattoos actually never happened.
We talked about getting matching tattoos on the inside of our lips.
Did you?
No, but we talked about it.
And everything I believe came tumbling down. Even though she told us she's an unreliable narrator, I really didn't expect this. Like, I don't know about y'all, but I found myself trusting what Rue told us, and I thought her unreliability was limited to those crazy tripping scenes we saw. But now, I'm questioning everything I saw in season one. Unfortunately, the Bridge episode was a huge reality check that confirmed we really don't know the whole story like we think we did. Not only did I truly have faith that Rue was gonna stay clean after Jules left, but I have faith in Rue. Am I crazy? Fuck no. I completely underestimated how much of an unreliable narrator she actually was and how delusional she possibly is. But luckily for you, I watched the season over again looking specifically for moments that could have been exaggerated or straight up fantasies, and this is what I came up with. Okay, so before I get started, I do want to preface this by saying I am exaggerating a bit by saying Rue lied. I understand she didn't necessarily lie, and it's more of her recalling events that she remembered, which she is very unreliable in doing so, but I have to clickbait somehow, honestly. So you'll see the points I do bring up are more like misrepresentations, exaggerations, or inaccuracies. I just want to say that before anyone jumps down my throat about it, because there will be other things worth jumping down my throat about, and this is not one of them. Alright, so this video will basically be divided into parts. The first where I cover exaggerations, fantasies, or whatever you want to call them. And the second where I cover some inaccuracies I found while rewatching the show. My goal really is to just dive into the true impact Rue being unreliable has for what we've seen so far in season 1, without relying too much on theories with no real evidence. While I was rewatching the season to make this video, I noticed most things that we could say were misrepresented mostly involve Rue and Jules' relationship. Meaning most of the unreliability is because of the way Rue perceives Jules' actions and their relationship as a whole. This leads to the first, and to me, most important point, that Jules was demonized a little bit. And no, I'm not saying Rue was narrating intending to make Jules out to be the bad guy, but we have to remember to take her feelings into account when we're only getting the story from her point of view. Rue placed Jules on a high pedestal, and since Rue is in fact the narrator, when Jules couldn't stand on that pedestal, some of the audience turned on her. And that happens to be the biggest example of the effect of Rue's unreliability. The fact that some fans out there blame Jules so much, solely based on what we saw in season 1. And they're not wrong, that's just how some people perceive the season. I personally believe they share the blame, but for the most part, their reasoning is that Jules led Rue on and she should have known Rue thought they're in a relationship. Sure, but what about Rue? Rue knew exactly what Jules wanted, and she's the one who told us, remember? Actually, exactly what Rue said Jules wanted is literally how their relationship panned out, until she caught feelings. And that's okay, but like I said, it's just an example.
Because that was the night she met her new best friend. And although she had never really been in a relationship, or even in, like, love, she imagined spending the rest of her life with her. How they live together in some shitty New York apartment and maybe date other people, but always sleep in the same bed. She even said it to her once, which was probably a mistake for like a lot of reasons.
Now you tell me what sounds more accurate. Them being best friends who sometimes sleep in the same bed and see other people, or them being in a relationship, Jules cheating on Rue, Jules telling Rue all about how she cheated on her and who she cheated with, and Rue doing literally nothing about it. Actually, Rue actively trying to hide how bothered she is. I don't know. That's a really, really tough one, but I'm gonna have to side with Jules on this one. Rue's misrepresentation of the facts has the biggest impact on how we perceive their relationship. When it came out that the tattoos actually never happened, it gave us some insight into how Rue thinks and what type of things could have been exaggerated. We also learned their relationship wasn't as strong as we originally thought, but knowing what I know now, I can say I think the purpose of this scene was to show how much Rue had fallen for Jules, especially since at this point in the season, Tyler was no longer a factor she had to worry about. It makes much more sense as a fantasy anyway. The scene leading up to the tattoo scene really ties it all together, and I mean, just hear me out. We've all had crushes and daydreamed about random scenarios of us being happy with them, right? I'm just saying, I think the daydream was happening while Rue was getting her hair braided, nothing too crazy. But anyway, based on what we know now, we know the tattoos are for sure complete bullshit. Rue tells her mom they had a long talk about it and they're gonna take it slow despite just telling her that they were kinda in a relationship.
Are you two in a relationship?
Yeah, kinda. It's fine, Mom. We had a really long conversation about everything and we're just gonna take things really, really slow.
Even though she contradicted herself there, there's also conflicting statements in what she told Ali. She told him they didn't even talk about being together enough to clearly establish a relationship because...
That's so weird.
What?
Why would we talk about it?
So do we still believe her and Jules talked about taking their non-existent relationship slowly when they wouldn't even talk about their relationship enough to establish it in the first place? I do want to point out that I've seen people say that the tattoos are actually real. She just felt embarrassed to tell Ali considering the direction their conversation was going. And trust me, I respect that opinion, but I don't see that being the case considering Ali's role in the show is to call Rue out on her bullshit, which he does plenty of times.
Listen, young blood. You're playing pool with Minnesota Fats.
Rue, you're high.
The scenes where Rue talks to Ali might be the scenes where we get the most truth out of Rue, and I'm not even trying to be funny. So I think it's safe to believe whatever Rue tells Ali to be the truth. With that being said, her conversation with Ali revealed a lot about her delusional ways. And y'all can drag me for this, but there are a few instances in the season where Rue is straight up lying to herself. One being the whole thing that we just talked about with her misrepresenting her relationship to people. But I have another perfect example if you really don't believe me. And honestly, it's simple, but it proves my point perfectly.
You really, really like him.
Who, Shy Guy 118?
His name is Tyler.
Doesn't really matter, both little fuckboy names.
He's not. For real, like, he's so sweet.
What school does he go to?
St. Mary's.
Ew, private school.
You're just jealous.
Aside from that being a really shitty thing to say, it's also not true. She'd just been acting weird all week.
I'm not jealous. I mean, you've been acting weird, like, all week.
What?
Now, everyone can tell that Rue was jealous. It was so obvious. She had something negative to say about literally everything Jules said about Tyler. Plus, they both thought the other was acting weird all week, which begs the question, who was the one really acting weird? It's not a huge deal, but when you think about the first time watching the show, you probably believed her in that moment. But we've all finished the season, and we all know she downplayed her feelings, so now the question is, why are you lying to yourself?
What do you gain from that?
I don't want to spoon feed you guys every instance I felt some delusion show through because I feel most could be left up to the viewer's interpretation. Plus, being able to watch this season over with a new perspective would be ruined if I just pointed out every single instance this applies to. Just understand the main theme of her delusions is Jules and their relationship, which puts us in a sticky situation as viewers when it comes to Jules. While half of us may feel one way, the other half may feel another, and we're all completely justified because we view things differently. But the beauty of the bridge episode is that it called out our narrator in a way that we didn't realize was necessary. Sad to hear how affected Rue was by her and Jules' situation, but this also opens up the opportunity to see the situation from a totally different perspective. And I could go deeper into this subject, but that would just be doing a deep dive on Rue's character, and that's another video for another day. But as a viewer, Rue's unreliability hits the hardest when it comes to Jules. Watching the season, we were forced to make judgments based on what we were shown and told. Then the bridge episode comes along and shows us an avenue where things may not be what they seem. Opinions on Jules, whether good or bad, is what's affected most by all of this misinformation. But what exactly does this mean for us? That has yet to be seen. To prevent this video from being 20 plus minutes long, I will be continuing on with this topic in parts. I'm also doing this to be able to put out a predictions video for Jules' episode in time and cover the bridge episode since I haven't yet. So if you're subscribed, I apologize for being AWOL. I've been on break from school and honestly just enjoying life, but I'm about to start posting videos regularly again. Also, if you made it to this point, let me know how you feel about everything I covered in this video, because I have a feeling I'm in the minority in the way that I think. And I know one thing specifically will piss a lot of people off, and I'm ready, so don't hold back. I do want to let y'all know I'm working on a theory video that I think will be very interesting. Plus, I have a new series I'm going to be working on pretty soon. So, yeah, I'm going to try my best to make the wait for season 2 suck less. But that's all I have for y'all. Till then.
they all lived happily ever after. And they all lived happily. And they all lived.